some coffee. Gonna do an interview in bed.
Who are you?
I am. I'm kidding. I'm Thomas. I'm Z's best friend. And, yeah.
How long have you known him?
I've known Z for... This is going on 6 years. Met in 2016. What is it? Yeah, so it was around summer 2016. We trained at Zero Gravity in Pomona together. At the time, he was even competing in men's physique as well. And I just started a prep with Ryan Benson, who's the coach there. I think Z was gonna start a prep too, but he had already been training there for a little bit. And yeah, so that's kind of where our story started, was in a bodybuilding gym. And we're still doing the same thing today.
How has he helped you? I know that he's got a lot that he could say about how you've helped him. Yeah. But how has he helped you, or how has your life changed since?
Man. It's crazy because, like, you asked that and there's so much behind it. I mean, honestly, I wouldn't, like, it's funny that you asked that too, because we were talking about this not too long ago, but I probably wouldn't be the man that I am if I didn't meet Z. I never really had, I mean, I've had best friends and everything, but Z is just definitely more like family to me. Like, if there's something closer than a brother, like, he's like my blood. He's helped me in so many aspects, like not just in bodybuilding, that's something that we connected with, but it goes way deeper than that. It's almost like we're kind of twins in a sense, and our personalities definitely like balance each other out. I mean, to tell you what he's helped me in is... He's just helped me be better. He's helped me be better with fitness. He's helped me be better as a man, as, you know, being responsible. You know, we've kind of, each year that we've known each other, we've just been leveling up with each other, like pushing one another. And it's also like we're in our 20s. So I feel like the end of the 20s are years that you're also developing a lot of character yourself. And it's like extremely important to be around the right people that you're in that developing stage with, because ultimately the people that are closest to you, you're going to be moving at that same pace, you know, sharing similar characteristics, and overall just made me a better man.
The place, Walmart, what do you need?
Just veggies.
Veggies? We need to get a Gatorade too.
Salam. Hasani. Parwana to Hasani. Dangubas. Hasan de. Salam. I'm here to know what to do. I'm going to get a little bit of 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 a little bit. خیلی خوب. اینا تامنو.
های.
های.
اینا چه یوتیوبه؟ تا عملی عملو. انشالله خیلی باش تا پنه ملا. خیلی خوب. قربان. موفقی بده. خواهد. That's part of the ritual. My parents are still back home, so show days I usually like to call my mom, my dad, send them good vibes, and then it's almost time to handle business, man.
Yeah.
Really excited for this one. It's gonna be a good day.
Oh, Mrs. Brown's client.
Oh.
Is this enough?
Yeah.
Cut, cut.
Thank you. Are you gonna have cookies too? Since 12, he's a classic pro. If you guys don't know him, I don't know what you guys are doing. He won this show last year and went to Olympia, so this year we're gonna do the same thing for him. Hold it down for Iranians, and this is for his
Harchambolos.
I'm getting him there.
That was your client, and he asked you, how do you think I did? What would you say?
If that was one of my clients, I would say you did great. You did great. We have to get back to finals and do better and finish this strong. Just stay focused. And that's what I'm doing myself too.
How was that for you?
The whole experience. That was brutal. I literally felt like my heart was gonna come out of my chest the entire time. But like I said, I've never seen anyone handle prep the way that this man has handled prep, and all his time and hard work has clearly shown on stage. I think that everything came together within these last few hours, and I think he brought the best package that he absolutely could. 10 out of 10.
Does he deserve it?
Absolutely. Like I said, conditioning wise, nobody can come close to him. I think that I've been there this whole prep. I've seen him do all the hard work, the nitty gritty, and he truly has given it all. No high carb, no cheat meals, nothing. He's just been absolutely 100% on his diet, his cardio. I think that his work ethic will clearly display on stage what he deserves, and it has.
How's it been living with someone so dedicated for the last year?
Honestly, it keeps me on track. It's been better for me to be with someone who's dieting all the time. He, like I said, no cheat meals, we're clean. It's good for me in general. my experience when I was on prep is that I was super moody and not the nicest person, but him, not one time did he snap, not one time did he lose control of his emotions. I am just so, this is our first prep together, I'm so impressed with how he can manage life, work, working out, doing cardio, dieting, doing online clients, training in-person clients, maintaining family relationships, our relationship. He handles it all so well, and it just comes together so seamlessly for him. And I think that it shows his status as an IFBB pro. This is what it means. He brings everything together in life and doesn't slack anywhere, on stage, in life, family relationships. I think that he just truly is the best person that I've ever seen in this sport, and I think that he deserves everything that is coming his way.
Outside of bodybuilding, what do you love about him?
Oh my God. So I've never met a person, and this sounds cheesy, but he genuinely loves me for me, and I love him for him. I think that we met each other in a time that allowed us to be vulnerable. Like the time that we met, we somewhat needed each other, and it kind of brought us closer in the end. So I think that we just mesh very well, and that's crazy because it's Gemini, and my Geminis are up and down. But for him, it's just we balance each other out. I know exactly when he needs some space, when he needs some time, and that plays a huge part in his prep. It's just these last 2 weeks, a lot of the time I let him be on his own, just giving him that space and time that he needs to get ready for the show. His mental state be solid.
I think he needed you for this show. I'm going to say that. You don't need to say that, but I think he did.
I was a good distraction for him, I would say.
Yeah.
It wasn't so all the time, like, I have to be this, I have to be that. I think that those nights we had in, we watched movies, you know, he was starving, he was hungry. He's bored, he's tired, but we stayed in, we watched movies, like we just talked. And I think that, one, that was quality time for us to have, but also it was a great little break for him from the whole mental side of bodybuilding.
What's up, guys? We're back to the crib, prejudging Manuel. Seems like top four for now. We don't want to judge early anything, but I'm happy with the package we brought. Definitely, I was conditioning-wise, I was one of the best, if not the best. So now we got 3 meals to get in, and I'm gonna wash off my tan just because I sweated a little bit, and then we have to go get a touch-up tan at 4:30, and then we go off to finals at 6. So fingers crossed. At this point, what helps you the most is getting these meals in. And also rest and nap. Nap is the key at this time. Here's my friend, client, the most quiet person you guys have ever seen. So if I wouldn't have introduced him to you guys, he would be best friend to hear his voice.
Yeah. Quiet people hate the camera. They hate it.
Just took a nice shower. Feels so good to rinse off. Now put some fresh clothes on. Gonna get my next meal ready. Have to cook rice again too. Then take a nap because nap does magic right now.